Elon Musk said Starship SN20 sported hundreds of improvements. Ship 20 is the next major technology rev. Those ships will be orbit-capable, with heat shield and stage separation system, ascent success probability is high. However, SN20 plus vehicles will probably need many flight attempts to survive Mach 25 entry heating and land intact. So what exactly are the differences of Ship 20 in addition to hundreds of internal improvements that SpaceX did not reveal? One of the enhancements is physically visible. First, SpaceX has significantly increased the number of heat shield tiles on this Starship prototype. SpaceX is preparing to launch the Starship into orbit, so what does the Starship's biggest flight ever mean for the future of space travel? SpaceX wants the Starship to be the rocket of the future, capable of carrying cargo and crew on long-duration interplanetary flights. But creating that future, well, that's taken a lot of work. There were early test flights with prototypes that looked more like tin cans than rockets, and there have been a few rapid and scheduled disassemblies. But SpaceX has also had a lot of success in a short amount of time. In May 2021, the company successfully launched the SN15 prototype, flying 10 kilometers or 6.2 miles into the air, before doing a belly flop and landing safely back on the landing pad. Now we're ready for Starship's first orbital flight. Unlike those earlier tests, we're not going to see a scaled-down rocket fly a few miles into the air. For this launch, we're going to see the full stack. The full stack refers to the Super Heavy rocket on the bottom and the Starship spacecraft up top. Now it's a little confusing, but SpaceX refers to both the spacecraft on top and the whole system, including the Super Heavy, as Starship. The Super Heavy rocket does the grunt work. It stands at 70 meters tall or 230 feet. In 9 meters wide, it has 29 Raptor engines which provide 72 mega newtons of thrust. That's a lot of numbers to throw at you, but essentially the Super Heavy is designed to give the Starship a massive boost into orbit. Ship 20 became the first Starship which have installed all 6 Raptors engine, and 3 of them is Raptor vacuum engines. These are used on an orbital Starship, so that it can travel at optimal efficiency in space. Musk has already confirmed on Twitter that this engine indeed is for Starship SN20 and for the first orbital flight. He also said that SpaceX is currently at 378 seconds of specific impulse, and targets over 380 seconds specific impulse down the road. Those are some awe-inspiring numbers, and in a nutshell mean that this engine is very efficient. S20 will be the first Starship to attempt to static fire with 6 Raptor engines, potentially producing more thrust than a Falcon 9 booster. Elon Musk used to say the best part is no part. SpaceX never stops improving. They have also continuously applied this rule on the Raptor engine. Looking at the appearance shows that the pine system around the Raptors have been refined and neater than before. Remarkably, its color is greener. It's easy to see. In addition, SpaceX also plans to use its Starlink internet on S20 in this flight in order to demonstrate high data rate communications between the new launch system and the ground throughout. The course of the trip to space and back, if it works, it could provide better than ever live data for SpaceX during its test flight. Once it's done that, it's designed to come back down and land on Earth. The second stage of the system, the 50-meter-tall Starship spacecraft, is what will one day carry cargo and human crew. It has a payload capacity of more than 100 tons, which according to Starship gives it the largest usable payload volume of any current or in-development launcher. The whole Starship system stands at 120 meters or 394 feet. It can carry 4,600 tons of propellant, in this case liquid oxygen and methane, most of which goes in the Super Heavy booster. SpaceX says the Starship will be the most powerful launch vehicle ever developed, capable of taking humans to the Moon, Mars and beyond. SpaceX's strict focus on maximizing the speed of Starship development and shortening the path to orbit. The company has frequently built Starship hardware before firmly assigning that hardware to any given ship, booster, or tank. In other words, until SpaceX actually begins stacking multiple completed rocket sections, there's always a degree of uncertainty about the fate of any given ring, dome, or tank barrel. NASA has already chosen the Starship as the rocket that will take the next astronauts to the moon, with the Artemis program, and this orbital flight is part of proving that SpaceX can do it now. Of course, this isn't the first high-profile space launch we've seen this year. Richard Branson flew with Virgin Galactic, Jeff Bezos flew in Blue Origin's New Shepard rocket. Both of these companies flew to the edge of space, 86 kilometers up in the case of Branson and 107 kilometers for Bezos. But that's a long way from orbit. Low Earth orbit where the space station sits, well, that doesn't start until 100 miles, or about 160 kilometers above Earth, spending a few minutes in microgravity, versus going all the way into orbit. Well, SpaceX is playing in a whole different ball game, so the main difference between what we've already seen from Blue Origin and Virgin Galactic, and some of those high-profile suborbital flights, is really, it has to do with altitude and with speed, and you need more of both of those to escape the gravity, well, of Earth in order to get up to orbit, which is kind of where a lot of the magic happens. To get into orbit, you need to escape Earth's gravity, and to do that, you need a whole lot more firepower, but that's where the Super Heavy and its 29 Raptor engines come into play, and with this orbital launch we'll get to see them in all their glory. According to documents, SpaceX filed with the FCC, the plan is to take off from the launch pad in Boca Chica, Texas, or as SpaceX is trying to rename the entire town, Starbase, Texas. The booster will separate from the second stage just under 3 minutes into the flight. That booster will then come back down and land in the Gulf of Mexico, approximately 20 miles from the shore. The Starship second stage will continue flying through the Florida Straits, and enter orbit before coming down for a quote powered targeted landing in the ocean, roughly 100 kilometers or 62 miles off the northwest coast of Kauai, in Hawaii. Now we've already seen a whole lot of action down at the SpaceX launch site, in Texas. Recently we've seen for the first time photos of all 29 Raptor engines installed, and they've even been spotted rolling it out of the high bay for the very first time. The hybrid is kind of this gigantic garage, so the message seems to be from SpaceX and Elon Musk that hey, we've got our gigantic booster, it's here, it's ready to thunder up. But SpaceX still needs approval to fly, from the FAA. Now of course SpaceX has ignored the FAA before. Back in 2020 it launched its SN8 prototype, despite being denied a safety waiver, the FAA said no, and SpaceX went ahead. Anyway, but regardless of that history, the Starship is still a little way off launching, so my best guess at where things are at with the FAA, and with the licensing requirements, I think we're probably at least a few months out. These things can sometimes take up to a year. Hopefully it doesn't take that long, but definitely a few months. You wouldn't get that from looking at the SpaceX and Elon Musk's Twitter feeds, where they're basically saying, hey look, we got a rocket ready to go still if everything goes to plan. This first orbital launch will be awesome to watch, not only SpaceX launching its mammoth rocket into orbit for the very first time, but a chance for the rest of us down here to see what the future of space travel could really look like. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.